music. Just going to put you guys on mute and share some sound. So I've got the Max Richter vibe. Can everyone hear me with the sound over the top? Give me a thumbs up. It's quite a quiet one. Turn your volume up if needed. Okay, so we're going to start with our feet just slightly wider than our hips. And if you can soften your knees, think of your tailbone sort of hanging down, but elongating up through the crown of your head. And we're going to open the arms, twist, look behind, touch the hands to the shoulders, and open and turn. Move to the middle, touch the hands to the shoulders. Breathe in as you open. Breathe out as you center. So just bringing your awareness into your body, noticing what you can see behind you each time. And can you open up your field of vision behind you with each one? Try to keep your hip bones facing forward so your legs stay still as you twist from the midsection of your body. And one more each way. Breathe. And then sliding the hand down the side towards your knee, coming back up, elongating up. We're going to tiptoe rise and then lower to the other side. So rising up onto tiptoes, two, three, and then lean. And coming up, tiptoe balance, and then lean, bringing the arm over to the side. And then opening on the tiptoes and then lean. And you get your arm back by your ear, straightening the arms, reaching now into your fingertip ends. So extending through to your fingertips. Inhale and exhale. And we're gonna do that one more time each way. So just getting the body moving, oiling the joints. And I'd like you to come and stand on the one leg, circling the knee out and around. We're going to circle through the hands and the wrists. And then reversing the leg and reversing the circle with the hands. Welcoming the wobble. If you can elongate up through the crown of your head. And then let's switch that to the other side. So circling the knee out and around. Circling with the hands, opening the fingers. And can you point your toes quite firmly? Gradually increasing the range of the circle and then reversing back the other way. Hello, Georgia, you having an apple? Alrighty, so last couple. And final one. Alrighty, we're gonna open the feet, a little bit of turnout through the toes. So we're in what they would call in ballet second position. I'm going to tuck the tailbone under. So I want you to feel like you're dropping your tailbone down behind and drawing your belly button muscle in as you go into a plie, keeping your back upright and then release. Do it again. So drawing the belly button muscle in, dropping down with the tailbone, adding some arms. We're going to open, two, three, and release. And do it again. Breathe. So using this as your breathing space of the day. If you like, you can go a bit lower, touching the back of the wrists at the top, opening out. Breathe. Do that twice more. Keep pressing your knees back towards your little toe side. So final one. And release. Alrighty, so either finding some bands or a stick. We're going to do some mobilization for our shoulders. So touching down behind, touching down in front. Breathing in on the way back, breathing out as you come forward. And as you do it, notice your fingers wrapped around the stick. Often when the wrists are tight, we'll tend to peel the fingers off backwards. So try to keep the grip on the stick as you take the stick behind. Now you can either stick with this version, or we're going to go around the world, touching down behind, and then reversing back in the opposite direction. So touching down behind, and then reversing back in the opposite direction. Alrighty, so last couple. Final one. And then we're going to take our feet just a little bit wider. Wider than the hips now, toes turned out. And I'd like you to bend your knee, taking your feet wide enough that as you bend your knee sits above your ankle. And then switch to the other side. So let the knee press out towards your little toe side and sit your bottom back. Now you might want to use your stick to monitor your posture as you come down. Can you keep it against your head and your tailbone with your hand just in the curve of the lower back? Just keep going, just letting someone else in. Well, for those of you doing the more advanced version of this now, you just touch down with the hand. So we come down. I'd like you to hold it for 3, 2, 1, whichever version you're doing. So we hold down for 3, 2, 1, and then make the switch. So we hold 2, 1, and make the switch. Last couple, keeping your bottom pushed back, body weight into your heels there. So final one, hold 2, 3, and then release. And we're going to bring our feet back together. So now's a good time to have a drink. So get some water. Let's keep topped up before we start on our mat work. So next up, we'll come down onto our back. So you can join me down here on the mat. Hey, Rodney. So we're going to bring our knees to our chest and then tap our feet down. So for level one on these, work at lifting your bottom off the floor. Use your hands to tuck to your chest. So you tuck, that's it, and then tap your feet down, breathing out as you tuck and in as you tap. For those of you doing level twos on these now, stick with level one if it's your first session today. Level twos, we're going to come up and hover so the feet are off the ground. We're really working on that rolling, smooth action through the back. For those of you doing more advanced work, level three, we're going to extend 2, 3, and then go into the roll. Can you lift your chest when you're in that balanced position? I'm going to do that 4 more times, reaching through your toes. Last couple. And final one. Okay, good job. So let's roll over onto our front. And we're going to place the hands just slightly wider than the shoulders like this. feet about hip width, pushing the ground away and aligning the shoulders. And as we push the ground away, sort of dig the heel of the hand into the mat, chin up, just having a check-in on how the back's feeling, and then lowering the body back down. So let's do that again. Pressing down through the shoulders, squeezing through the glutes, chin up, and then lowering the body back down. Drawing the belly button muscle in as you lift, chin up, two, three, and then lower. Breathing in on the lift. Breathing out on the lower. Can we do that twice more? Holding at the top for three, two, one, and lowering. So final one, squeezing the glutes, holding at the top. Three, two, one, and then lowering the body down. From here, we're gonna meet up here in our downward dog. So if you can have your hands at the edges of the mat, feet hip width, pressing down through the heels, deep breath. If you can now wriggle your feet back another inch or two and press down more firmly through the heels, just checking in, how are the calves feeling today? I'm going to transfer the body weight to one side. So notice now I'm flexing the foot on one side and pushing down through the heel like this on the other. Pressing down on the one side, flexing through the toes on the other. So often our toes get crammed into shoes and trainers throughout the day. So just working at giving your feet a good move around, getting some flex into your toes. Particularly if you get that stiffness around your toes, the movement helps to lubricate something called the synovial fluid in the joint. So helps with that moving around of fluid in the joint, which brings all our natural painkillers into our joints. So last couple and final one. And then we're going to take a walk with our feet towards our hands, and if you can come and lay down onto your back, we're going to turn our palms so they face upwards, curling the tailbone under as we squeeze the glutes and lift, squeeze through your knees, and then imprint down middle back and lower back. And let's give that another go. So coming up, squeeze through your glutes, holding there at the top, and then imprinting middle back and lower back to come down. Now the next one, we're going to pause and stay at the top, and we'll do some little focal points. So I want you to squeeze your knees towards each other, squeeze your glutes quite firmly, and push your feet down. So there's a real sort of tension around the back, the hips, the glutes, the legs, and then soften that tension as you lower. So let's do that focus again. Curling up, squeezing the glutes, pushing down through your feet, squeezing your knees. So you're feeling that tension and then imprinting, softening the muscles bit by bit. Let's do that again. Curling up, feel the squeeze again, and you hover your arms now up over the top of your head and just touch your thumbs down on the floor, but squeeze your upper arm towards your ears. So there's tension now through the arms as well as the legs, and then arms coming back in and imprinting down bone by bone. So let's give that another go, relaxing at the bottom but then applying that tension as you lift, squeeze the buns, squeeze the knees, push the feet down, taking the arms up and over, upper arm towards your ear, breathe, reaching the fingers, and then arms coming back in and softening that tension through the legs. Can we do that twice more? Squeezing, tensing as we lift, extending through the arms. Breathe, reaching the fingers, arms by the ears. Softening and relaxing to come down. Let's do that one more time. Lifting up, squeeze the buns, squeeze the knees, push down through your feet. Reaching the fingers, extending into your fingertip ends, and then releasing and imprinting through your middle back, through your lower back. Notice I'm now extending up with my right leg, so if you could do the same. That's it, and then bringing the opposite hand here on the calf, other hand around the back of the thigh, and then straightening the leg so that you're sort of pushing the hands and the leg towards each other, pointing the toes quite firmly. So again, there's tension through that leg. Level two, we're gonna extend the bottom leg down and pull the top leg in more firmly. So you're almost thinking of bringing your shin towards your face. For third level, more advanced, notice I'm now bringing my nose and my knee towards each other. Keep reaching out through that bottom leg and then coming back down, and let's repeat that on the other side. So extending the other leg up, opposite hand on the calf. Point your toes quite firmly there. Level two, we're going to extend the bottom leg down, pulling more firmly on the top leg, thinking of the shin coming towards us. Breathe, pushing the hand into the leg and the leg into the hand. Bringing the nose and knee towards each other, more advanced. Breathe. Alrighty, so let's rest off, use that leg just to bring ourselves up to a seated posture. Now, if it's tricky to get down and up off the floor at the stage you're at, then hook a band or a strap, something stretchy. You can use a towel, a jumper, something under your feet to help yourself get down and back up. Or level two, we do it hands-free like this. Tucking the tailbone under, rolling the spine along the ground, and then lifting. Inhaling on the roll down, and exhaling on the lift. Over time, for more advanced, we bring the arms here back by the ears. So third level, more advanced, arms back by the ears. Do that four more times. Eye gaze up to the ceiling helps the head alignment, and then looking forwards when we're in the seated position. So eye gaze up on the roll down, looking at the ceiling on the roll up, and then looking straight ahead as we sit. So last couple, aiming for that smooth quality movement. Final one, and then from there, if you can lay your body down on the ground, bringing your right knee up to your chest, pulling the knee towards you as we move into a sacroiliac joint stretch. We're going to bring the leg across the body like this, placing the foot down, pressing with the hand, knee towards the ground. Notice I'm trailing this hand behind me. I want you to stretch it out so the hand sits just above your shoulder, so that we're now getting some stretch around the front of the chest through the pec, and then looking towards the back shoulder, pressing down through the knee and the shoulder at the same time. Breathing in through the nose as we breathe out, pressing down through the shoulder, through the knee. Let's do that again. Deep breath. One more deep breath. Alrighty, let's give that a go on the other side. So if you can swap the knees, tuck it up like this to your chest. There we are. And then and you bring your foot slightly away from your body as you bring the knee down. Use the hand to press the knee, feel for the floor with the knee or thereabouts, and where's that hand behind? Can we get it just above the shoulder line? Turning to look towards the back hand, can you look behind your shoulder? Breathe deeply. Pressing down through the shoulder as we exhale. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, press down through the shoulder, through the knee. One more deep breath. Alrighty, if we can roll to the center and then use that leg with your hands just here around the back of the thigh to rock yourself up to a seated position. So now's a good time to grab a drink. So if you'd like to have a little drink. And next up, we're going to do some squats. We're going to work on squat technique. Now, if you want to, you can use weights, or particularly if you've struggled with stiffness in your back, I'd recommend you start with a stick. So we'll use the stick, so it's attached to the head, the shoulders and the tailbone. And we want the knuckles and the lower back sandwiched together. Feet slightly wider than your hips. Think of your knees heading towards your smaller toes rather than rolling in over your big toes. And coming back up. And let's do that again. Can you draw your belly button muscle in so that you can feel your knuckles and lower back stay together for good alignment through the spine? Over time, once you've mastered that and you know you've got good core control, start to bring some weights in. So just grabbing some weights. So 2 or 3 kilos usually to start with, and you can build up over time. So holding each one for 3, 2, 1. Swap your arms around if you're using the stick. So you also do it on the other side. Level 2 will bring the weight out in front of us. But for level 3s, we're going to bring the arms up and back by the ears, but checking in on what the lower back does. Can we still keep the core active? We've got 3 more to go. Holding down for 3, 2, 1. So final one. Alrighty, let's shake a leg. And if you can find your stick, I'm gonna place it along the back. And again, I want you to feel for your knuckles and your lower back together. Now, if you can see yourself in your screen, ideally you want to see yourself from a side view. Use your screen as your mirror. Can you get this knee back to the other knee? So the knees are in line. Are we in forward lean on the screen, or can you bring your stick so it looks upright? Heel towards your bottom. Now, can you squeeze your bottom and push your hip bones forwards? Now, you can either stay with this version. If you've got your heel sandwiched to your bottom, then see if you can test your balance. How's the balance today? Can you get that leg at the back lifted as you hold? More advanced, we're going to lift the leg higher up. We're going to push the foot into the hand. Press the hand into the foot. And roll the shoulder back at the same time to get some stretch around the front of that arm and into the bicep. Let's release off and give the legs a shake. Okay, how's that looking on the other side? So use your screen again as your mirror. Can you get the stick sitting upright? How does it look to you? How's that knee? Can you bring the knee back to the other knee? Are your knuckles and lower back together as you hold the stick against your head, your shoulders, your tailbone? Is your heel on your bottom. Can you squeeze in and push your hip bones forwards? Use your eyes to steady your balance. If you want to move to next level, test your balance. Let's add that forward lean. Breathe. Use your eyes, look at something still to focus your attention. Add more lift through the back leg. Get some height in that back leg if you're doing more advanced. Roll the shoulder back, opening into the bicep. Sandwiching the big toe joint down on that foot that stays on the floor. And let's release and give the legs a shake out. Okay, time for another drink. It's a hot one tonight. Now, if you've got your flannel, your wet towel there, I want you to just wring it out. Use it to mop the brow or around your face. Have a little bit of cold therapy. Here on the back of the neck is actually the quickest way to cool your body temperature down. We've got lots of arteries and veins there, so just popping it there to give yourself a little cool down. Oh, quite therapeutic. Little facial. Oh, nails and a facial today. Lucky me. No kids around. Whew. Okay, so next up, we're going to do some curls, oysters, I mean. So we'll use the stick. For those of you doing the more advanced version now, if you've got some ankle weights, then you might want to pop those on. We'll go through three different levels again. So if you come and lay down onto your side, we need the stick attached to the head, the shoulders, and the tailbone. So oysters, great way to keep our bones happy, actually, and our hips. Good prevention, preventative exercise for hip issues. So we're gonna bring our knees up in front of our hip, like that, and the head, the shoulders, the tailbone, against the stick. Now, before you start to move, pull your shoulder blades down. So for me, I use this hand just here to press the blades down the back and then lift up the waistline. Now, see if you can keep the waistline lifted as you just hover your top leg. And then we're going to keep that leg hovered as we roll the knee back. One, squeeze the buttock. Two, three, and then hover down, and we'll flex the feet with the top leg hovered. So we're not going to drop that leg. It's staying hovered, and we point the toes again. One, two, squeeze, three, and then flex and hover again. So keep the leg hovered, and then pointy toes again as you open, squeeze the glutes, and then hover back down. For level two today, we're going to open the knee and then reach into an extended leg, control the leg on the way down, and fold back in. So we point the toes as we open the knee, keep reaching the toes upwards, controlling back down and back in. For third level, we're moving up into a side plank position. So we're up on the bottom elbow. And I'd like you to do it three more times. Now, is the stick still attached to your head, to your shoulders, to your tailbone? So final one. Alrighty, so relaxing off. Let's swing our leggies around to the other side. So head, shoulders, tailbone, again, lined up against the stick, feet forwards, and we're gonna lift up from the waistline before we start to move. So hovering the top leg, rolling the knee back. One, two, three. I'm gonna flex the feet. So we point the toes as we open the knee, and then flex as we come down. good squeeze through the glute. Now the key is not to roll the top back hip so it wanders backwards. You'll need to keep some effort and focus on keeping that hip forwards. Then we extend, ooh, losing a leg weight. Or for more advanced, we're gonna bring ourselves up onto that bottom arm. Squeezing, making a fist with that bottom hand. So final one. Alrighty, so resting off. If you can pop the leg weights off, have another drink if you need one. Good to keep topped up, especially if you're playing a bit of catch up on the water tonight. Plenty to drink. Alrighty, so we're gonna meet back in our downward dog. So if you can hook your toes underneath, lift your tailbone up in the air. Now you can either stay with a regular down dog, or we're gonna place one foot directly in the middle as we just draw a slow sort of semicircle with the other leg, pointing the toes, reaching up for the ceiling. And then if we just have a little look up, where, how high is that foot? Can you get it so it looks like it's up towards the ceiling? And then slowly controlling that leg as it comes back down, placing the foot on the floor, pressing down through the heels, lifting up through the toes on the other side. Having a look back, how does that leg look? What's the height of the leg like? And then controlling the leg as we come down. And from here, we're gonna go into a groin stretch. So opening the knees like this. Notice my knees are actually off the edges of the mat like that, and the toes are touched together. And then moving the elbows forward. So we're in a plank, arching your back. So let your back arch, eye gaze forwards. And if you can just push your bottom back slightly until you feel a stretch in the groin. So sort of coming back and down. Breathe. Inhale through your nose. Exhaling through your mouth. More deep breath. So just using this as your breathing space today. Alrighty, so from here we're going to move up to an all fours position, and I'd like you to find your stick, and we're going to see if we can keep the stick along the back, testing really our core stability by placing the stick there. Notice I've got my knuckles, the curve of the back. So we're looking for sort of knuckle full of space as the leg extends away and lifts. And then bringing the leg back in, can we transition to the other leg, lifting the leg up high enough that the buttock muscle kicks in. Once you've mastered maintaining the core, keeping the stick steady for level one, we start to reach the opposite arm away from the leg, getting some height on the arm so the arm comes up by the ear, pushing the ground away with the hand that stays on the floor. For next level, we're gonna stay in that reach position. We'll add some fold through the back leg like this, so the heel closes towards your bottom, keeping the thigh lifted as we extend back out. Can we transition to the other side? So into the Superman, Superwoman, Superperson, holding for level three, extending back out. So whichever version you're doing, see if you can keep the stick steady. Stick usually gives you stick on these when you first start them. last one on each side. Breathe. Keep your belly button muscle drawn in to keep your core active. Alrighty, so from here, we're going to take a sit back into our child pose, opening the knees, feet together, and reaching the fingers away along the mat, just pressing the palms down, resting the head down, breathing in through the nose into the belly and exhaling out. So just using this as your breathing space today. Imagine you're breathing in positive, healthy energy, exhaling out any stresses and tensions. And one more deep breath. So we're gonna come back up to all fours. So then if you can bunny hop through, or however you like, coming down onto your back. And we're going to do a little more core work. So have your fingertips in the curve of your lower back. I'd like you to pull your belly button muscle in so you've got pressure on both of your hands. Trying to maintain that pressure as you tap down with your heel and come back in. Now, if you've got that good pressure, level two, so we're going to bring our knees to 90 degrees, continuing that good pressure between the left and right. And if you've got a particularly bad back and you're losing the pressure on your hands, then I want you to stick with level one. For those of you with a strong back and core now, level threes, we're going to do opposite, like this, taking the hands out and moving opposite arm over the top of the head, keeping that control around the core. Use your feet as well. We're going to flex and then point. Flex and then point. Last couple. Final one. Okay, good job. And then from here, we're going to bring our right leg over our left. Let's move into a glute stretch. So parking the hands just at the back of the thigh, use the hands to pull the leg inwards. Pulling in firmly, notice, scale of 1 to 10, how firm does that feel? Use your elbow to push the knee out. 10 being an unbearable stretch, 0 being no feeling at all. Scale of 1 to 10, how strongly do you feel that right now? Breathe. Now you can either stay with this version, or notice now I'm interlacing here around the front of the shin. And then use the hands just to pull in more firmly and pushing that knee out. Breathe. Alrighty, let's switch that over to the other side. So we slide the hands around, well, a sweaty knee in my case. You can use your hands to pull in, use the elbow to push out. So again, scale of 1 to 10, how is that stretch feeling? Can we aim for a 6, 7 as we do the pull in, pushing out with the elbow? Pressing down through the shoulders, opening the collarbones. Breathe. Drawing the chin in to elongate the back of the head and the neck. Breathe. Can we interlace the fingers around the front of the shin and keep pressing the knee outwards? Now, sometimes on these, the body weight will shift to one side. Can you centralize your body weight? Alrighty, so let's release. We're going to move over to all fours. And I would like you to bring your knees under your hips and your hands just slightly wider than your shoulders. Now we're going to take an arch with the back and then around into a cat stretch. So chin to chest and then arch, look up, breathing in. And then an exhale and around. And then from there, I'd like you to go into what we call neutral spine, letting your chest lower towards the ground, lift, and then again, arching up, rounding the back into a neutral spine and allow your chest to lead the way. For more advanced on these now, we'll arch, round, and then from here we're going to move to tiptoes with a neutral spine and let the chest lead the way. So we drop the knees, arch, round. So find your level with it. I'd like you to do it four more times. Breathe. So three more. Last couple. And final one. Alrighty, and again, once you're finished, we're going to sit back into child pose, toes together, knees open. Watch where the hands go. They're sliding down. So the palms are face up now, allowing the shoulders to soften, just sort of round forward, tucking the head in, bit of a snail-like pose. Breathe. So just really letting your shoulders soften. Use this as your breathing space, little snail sort of tucked up inside its shell. The nice thing about a snail is it's got everything it needs on its back. Breathe. Alrighty, so if you'd like to have a drink, we're gonna come up to standing next. I'd like you to find your stick and we're going to use it for some stretches around the muscles called levator scapula, which is the muscle which elevates our shoulders. Common site of tension, particularly when we've been doing a lot of desk work. So if you can walk your hands towards each other here, and if you can pull, like you're trying to pull the stick apart, and then turn your head and look down over your shoulder. Take your body weight into your heels. Breathe. And let's release. So if we could do that again, keeping the hands towards each other, gripping and pulling. Turn, look down. Breathe. And let's release. And we'll do that one more time. So gripping, pulling, turn, look down. Allow your tailbone to drop. Alrighty, so how does that compare on the other side? Sometimes we've had issues around our neck or our shoulder. One side can feel much easier and freer than the other. I know that was certainly the case for me when I was rehabilitating a frozen shoulder. So deep breath. Let's release. So walking the hands a little closer together, grip and pull. Certainly for me it was doing these on a consistent basis, definitely quite painful at times, but just working through it helped the two sides to even out and to get that mobility back into the shoulder. And let's do that one more time. So grip and pull, like you're trying to pull the stick apart. eye gaze looking down. Breathe. Ah, so we're nearly there. From here, I'd like you to touch your fingertips together behind your back. So you're just going to feel for your fingertips and your thumb tips touching together. Now, for some of you, that may feel enough. Depends on the mobility around your shoulders and your wrists and forearms. The next level, see if you can bring your fingers more together and your thumbs together. Get a little bit of height up your back. Now, as you do that, see if you can roll your shoulders backwards so you're not going into a rounded shoulder. You're feeling your shoulders squeeze towards each other. And then for more advanced level, we're going to take the hands higher up and the heel of the hand together, still working at that roll back in the shoulder and the lift in the breastbone. Deep breath as you hold. And release off, allowing the head to drop to one side and placing your hand here by your ear. Just give into gravity with your head. Deep breath. And release and allow your head to give into gravity on the other side and a gentle pull by the ear. Breathe. Placing the hands at the back of the head, chin down, touching the chin to the chest, and applying a bit of pressure around the back of the skull. Breathe. Alrighty, so I'd like you to find your cold flannel again. So if you can just wring that out, and if you can fold it up, we're just going to place it here over the top of the head. It's a good look. And we're going to use it as part of our relaxation today. Help us cool off and chill out. So if you can come down onto your back, we're going to place our hands here, one hand above your belly button and one hand below. Closing your eyes. And just taking a moment of self-appreciation. So a little yay me moment for getting the exercise done today, sweating it out despite the heat. Could have been an excuse not to do it, but we did it. So just giving yourself a little bit of self-appreciation, but also thinking about how little mini habit of deciding to do it today just adds up to your bigger picture of your mobility, flexibility, strength, posture, mindset, well-being, resilience, independence, and how your energy doing these things on a regular basis helps to influence the energy of people around us, the people that we care about, people that we come into contact with each day. So we need to breathe that energy in and out. Allow your belly to fill up with air. And empty. Just tuning into that natural flow of breath rising and falling inside your belly. Just let your arms flop at the side of you. Ragdoll-like with the arms, floppy arms, and let your legs drop, let your feet flop, allow your body to sink down, feeling the contact of the body against the ground. Relaxing the back of the head into the ground. Let it nestle down. Softening the shoulders. Just running your attention down your spine. Imagining you've just relaxed twice as much. Sinking down deeper into your relaxed, calmer place. Noticing the energy of that calmer place. Change thoughts in your head as you sink into that calmer place. Perhaps there's less thoughts. More of the being mode and less of the doing mode. Bringing some of that energy back into the room. So we slowly open our eyes, just notice what's in our peripheral vision. Sliding the feet back in. And when you're ready, if you can roll over to your side and just getting yourself back up. When you feel ready, just hitting your mute button for me. I'm just gonna take a moment to stop the share of the sound and we'll have a little check-in and just see how are we feeling.